get ready to match the stars. Clifton Davis, Brett Summers, Gary Berghoff, Joanne Flew, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Flagg as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75.
Hello, ladies.
I don't know, but
that's your fan mail for the week.
That's my fan mail for the week. You got a routine to go with this.
No.
You're dying.
I don't even have a contract for the next week's show.
I have a public announcement.
You have an announcement?
It's a public announcement. This will be Gary Berghoff's last show. He's going to the psychiatric division of UCLA as soon as the show is over.
That's right. I'm going to be a doctor.
No, he's going to be a patient. Ignore him.
Right. All right, I take it you're all ready to have a go at it.
Oh.
Would you welcome our two civilian players here, Judy Jennings and Vicky Hackey. Hello, ladies. How are you? Judy's our current champ. She's won $600, and she's happy about that. And she's going to be challenged by Vicky Hacking. Would you please tell us a little bit about yourself?
Yes, I'm from Canoga Park, California. I have four children, and I have a darling husband right there. And I'm so glad to be here. You know, it's just fun to see all of you celebrities. One thing's kind of bothered me, though, during the past year, and that's that my friend up there, Brett, always seems to be picked on by all of you guys, and I've kind of felt bad about it. And so I brought her a gift, and I hope that she will accept it.
What is
that? The dandruff off her clothing.
The gift she has for you is this book. It says...
Oh, I love it. It says, I need all the friends I can get.
That's right.
Fanny, yes.
Vicky, you know we really love her, don't
we
you?
Do.
Yes.
Truly. We also love dumb animals.
Honey, that's what I was going to say.
Okay, Vicky, nice to have you with us. We'll start this game right after we have a word or two from one of your friends. Chatting, having a friendly time here. Now we're ready to start the game. Vicky, would you make a selection?
B.
All right. Vicky's got her fingers crossed.
Be cool,
and hopes
man.
That she's going to match a lot of you celebrities. Dr. Wong said to Selma, he said, I offer two different kinds of acupuncture. For $100, I stick you with fine, delicate needles. For $1, I stick you with Brink. That's what Dr. Wong said.
I want that question read in its entirety once more.
Two different kind of acupuncture. For $100, I stick you with a very fine, delicate, skinny needle. But for $1, I stick you with Brink. Say you want $100, one from column A, one from column B. Column A, $100. Column B, $1.
Doesn't Brett look nice tonight? Really? Brett looks very pretty today.
Don't talk while a lady think. Lady can't write and talk and think at the same time. Lady not too smart.
I can't walk and chew gum at the same time. I'll stick you with, what's his name?
For one.
That's the answer.
You hurry up, or I'm gonna poke you right in the nose if you don't hurry up.
That's a kind of acupuncture.
For $100, I stick you with a fine, delicate needle. For $1, I stick you with Brink.
My mind's gone blank. It's gone absolutely blank.
This lady.
Can I help?
Would you like some artificially flavored pineapple?
Okay, excuse me. Would you push your chair a little closer there? All right, everybody ready? Now we come to Vicky Hacking. I offer two different kinds of acupuncture. For $100, I stick you with very fine, delicate needle. For $1, I stick you with Brink.
Chopstick.
Chopstick. The audience seems to like her response of chopstick. What say you to that, Clifton?
I say your accent didn't lead me there at all.
No?
No. I thought, well, with a very fine needle, if for $1, he would get a nail.
A nail.
That's right, a nail.
Okay. All right, Brett.
Your little accent led me straight to Chinatown.
Yeah.
And you just picked on me and made fun. And stuck me with stick.
How about that? Chopstick and stick, okay. So there's one match. How about it, Gary?
I'm slow, but I'm smart.
Yes.
Not to mention pushy.
I thought we were doing doctor jokes, see, and I didn't get the Chinese doctor and all that, and I thought it was you were talking about my doctor. That's what I thought.
What?
And stuck you with the bill.
Stuck you with the bill. For $100, I stick you with fine, delicate needle. For $1, I stick you with blank. What do you say to that?
Ouch.
Ouch.
I was trying to think of something that would be a heavy, thick needle, which would be just the opposite of a thinning needle.
You didn't think a chopstick I'd take it?
No.
What do you say?
Knitting needle.
You put knitting show to people a dumb answer. Knitting needle. There it is. Dumb answer. Very good. No, it's a good answer. Dull instrument. Speaking of dull instrument, what do you say, Richard?
I see you read my divorce papers. I had acupuncture for my back.
You had acupuncture?
750 needles.
Oh, really?
Oh. Did it hurt?
Yeah, well, then it cured the back. Only every time I drank a glass of water, I had to wear a raincoat.
It's a knitting needle.
Knitting needle. Two knitting needles, Vicky. All right, Fanny Flagg.
All right, Vicky, anybody that likes sweet bread and is sweet to her deserves a good answer, a chopstick.
There it is. Okay, that's two for you. Your question coming up in a minute or so. Right now, we got a message for you, and this is it. All right. Now, we're in the middle of round one. We've got a question for Judy. Vicky scored two with her round. Everybody plays in this one. Fred said, I saw the strangest thing at the racetrack today.
Oh, did he?
Just before the race, horse number one snuck out of his stall and blanked on horse number six. Just before the race, horse number one snuck out of his stall and blanked on horse number six.
That's what horses do. He doesn't like my answer, but that's exactly what
horses do. Wrong.
What is that?
Fred said, I saw the... Now, just think about this.
Honey, I'm finished.
Oh, yeah, I'm not talking. I'm talking to her. I saw the strangest thing at the racetrack today. Just before the race, horse number one snuck out of his stall and blanked on horse number six. It's a strange occurrence.
Oh, you can say that again. This entire question is a strange occurrence.
A strange occurrence. You want to talk to him? I don't care if you talk to him. What do I care?
Get your hands up.
You sure that Gary are ready?
Gene.
Joanna's ready. Richard's ready. And old Fanny's the only one now.
You sure Mr. Ed started like this?
I'm ready now.
All right.
All right.
Now, Judy, Fred said, I saw the strangest thing at the racetrack today. Just before the race, horse number one snuck out of his stall and blanked on horse number six.
Tinkled.
Well, it wasn't easy for her to say that, can't you see?
Yes, I know. It was very painful, but I don't think that's the best answer. It may score for her, but we'll find out right now. Go, Clifton.
I swear, what day were you at the track? I was at Santa Anita, and I saw that horse, and it was most embarrassing because he tinkled.
Oh, okay. Right on the other horse. Kind of strange about that. Okay, Brett, you're on.
Honey, they're both wrong. Poor little devils, they don't know nothing.
What?
This horse number one thought he was a jockey, for heaven's sake. He jumped on horse number six.
I see. Okay, Gary, you're on
Secretariat.
Now.
Your turn. Am I really?
You're on.
This is incredible. I haven't got the slightest idea what the answer to this was. I wouldn't say tinkled. I said ran. I'm sorry. Ran.
Done.
He was eager.
Done.
Turning on you, Gar.
Okay. Lady with the naked back. Would you give us your answer, please?
Yes.
Well, I couldn't say that, Judy.
What did you say?
Well, I just had to go to something else. And I thought maybe he got carried away and he sat on him.
That would be a strange thing.
Have pity on her. She's going to be a mother.
Yes, listen, I emphasized it as much as I could.
But that
the
was
strangest thing at the racetrack.
I've never seen a horse.
Now, why?
Horse.
Listen, you want to hear a good answer? Richard, show us your good answer.
Okay. I was at Santa Anita and had a dream. All I could see was sevens in the dream. And I went there and I looked at the date. It was the 7th of July. I thought, fantastic. It was 7 to 1. I put $7 on. Came 7th. And then it tinkled.
Okay. I don't know what the answer is.
You finally figured it out. Fanny, did you figure it out? What? Go.
Ran, yes. Tinkle.
Now, if you went to the racetrack and you saw a strange course, a strange thing happening, a strange occurrence, it would be a horse sneaking out of a stall and going to the window and say, put $2 on number one. That would be strange.
Read the question.
Why didn't I think of that?
The strangest thing at the racetrack today. Just before the race, horse number one snuck out of his stall and bet on horse number six.
Yeah, but by the ED. You left off the ED.
ED.
Betted on horse number six. Is that why you didn't
wager?
He bet is just the past tense. Will you continue with the game?
He's in charge of us. That's the terrible.
Now, listen. Bet is the past tense. All we do is indicate the past tense with the ED. That's all we do.
Well, you missed it.
You thought it had to end in ED?
Well,
I'm glad we straightened that out. Oh, the producer's listening. Okay. Would you please brief the celebrities before we do the next shot?
I'll push this button,
and the thing goes down, and the score is 3-2 in favor of Judy. Vicky, please make a selection.
B again.
All right. Brett and Fanny do not play.
Oh.
Sylvia said, my husband, Carl, is a nut. When he sings in the shower, he insists on having a blank in there with him. My husband, Carl, is a nut. You do. When he sings in the shower, he insists on having a blank in there with him.
And I know that Vicky's going to come up with it.
This is really another easy one. And there's no EDs involved in this.
Oh, yeah.
He did. All right. Okay. All right. Everybody ready? All right. Just put in a slot, Clifton. Leave that boy alone.
Right, Gene. I'm sorry. It's a little
Vicky,
slow up here.
Sylvia said, my husband, Carl, is a nut. When he sings in the shower, he insists on having a blank in there with him.
I'm going to say woman. Didn't like it, did you? They didn't like it. They didn't like it.
Well, I don't think you're going to get any women out of this bunch. What do you say?
Oh, I'd love to have a woman in the shower with me.
That's not the point.
No,
I have that as part of my answer, an accompanist.
Yes.
Piano
accompanist. Yes. All right. Now, Gary.
He said that this was another easy one.
It's an easy one. And so he says I have an accompanist in there with him. That's a good answer.
Easy. I said he had a bookie in there with him.
I
put a bet on number six. There's another answer, and I said microphone.
Isn't that microphone? Good one? Well, that's okay. Okay. All right, Joanne.
Thank goodness.
Well, my husband's a singer.
Yes.
And he likes to sing, when he sings, lots of accompaniment. So the only thing I can figure, if he's a real nut, he'd like to have a full orchestra.
That's okay. Now, you got to match Richard to stay in the game, Vicky. Let's see it happen. She's looking for the answer, woman. He insists on having a woman in there with him.
I thought he was a soloist. I said instrument.
An instrument in there. Sorry to see you go so soon, Vicky.
Super fun. Enjoyed it.
Well, it was a pleasure meeting you. You're a sweet lady, and we've got a gift for you. Vicky Hacking, ladies and gentlemen. Goodbye. All right. Shall we begin? Okay. We polled a recent studio audience, Judy. Remember, we got their best response to this. Francis Blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500.
If you match it, if you match the next one, you get $250, and the bottom one, $100. Whom do you choose on for a little bit of help?
Clifton.
Clifton, what do you say to that? Francis?
What you got, honey?
I have two good ones, and I want
to... Just say one.
Francis Scott Key.
Francis Scott Key. Okay, there's one.
Fanny. Francis the Mule. Oh.
Francis the Mule.
Gary.
Gary, have you got one? Mm.
Yes, the best friend Francis the Mule ever had, Francis of Assisi.
Francis of Assisi. Okay, so you got Francis Scott Key, Francis of Assisi, and Francis the Mule. Now, you can choose one of those, or if you think there's a better one, you may give us that. What is your decision?
Francis the Mule.
Francis the Mule? You're letting his audience influence you, aren't you?
No, I had already thought of it.
Oh, you'd already thought of it. Okay. We're looking for Francis the Mule. Francis the Mule, where are you? Well, we'll start down at the bottom, shall we? Shall we reveal the $100 response? Francis Drake. You all remember her?
Yeah.
Story.
Drake written down. I don't want any person passed upon the English.
But his phone number, too.
Good. All right, looking for Francis the Mule. Here is the $250 response. Francis Scott Key is the one Clifton gave you.
We're in the money.
Last chance for Francis the Mule. May we reveal the $500 response. Francis the fucking Mule. Congratulations. You got $1,200 now. Okay, and that means you're going to play for $5,000. Remember to collect. You got to match one of them head-to-head. It has to be exact. Which one will it be?
I think I'll take Clifton.
You'll take Clifton.
Oh, my. Right. That's sweet of you. Richard's throwing things. You know what I wrote down, and then I said Francis Scott Key. I had the talking mule written down. Yeah. Isn't that something?
Right. Well, we...
I kicked him, but he didn't do any good. He went with Francis Scott Key.
You get ready to write Clifton, and here we go. For $5,000, powder blank. Powder blank. Powder blank. Okay, he's finished. Now, Judy, we need an answer from you which you think will match his. What do you say to that? Powder?
Puff.
Powder puff. All right, Clifton. She says powder puff will match you. May we see it for $5,000, please?
I'm sorry. Powder room.
Powder room.
We had it.
Puff,
yeah. I was going to say puff, and she kicked me.
Well, listen, you've got your $1,200, and you're still the champ, Judy. You're going to play another game after this message. Hello there. Okay, Judy's ready to play another game, and to do that, we have to have another player. So let's welcome Don Robbins. Hello, Don.
Hi. How are you? Very fine, Jim. Thank you.
Good. Don is now going to tell us a little bit about himself. Would you please, sir?
Well, Gene, I was born and raised in Baltimore, Maryland. I'm a licensed embalmer by trade, went into dancing, and currently for 27 years in the food and beverage business in hotels.
You're a dancing embalmer?
That's where it stands.
That is, don't you?
No, what is a dancing embalmer?
A lucky stiff.
Where do you live now, Don?
Hawaii.
You live in Hawaii?
Yes.
Uh-huh. What are these things, if I may ask?
These are semi-precious kukui nuts. They were worn by the royalty, and these are very popular in Hawaii. The brown are very rare.
They are. Yeah, that's what
I
keep saying. The brown is very rare. That is.
You're going to get laughs at the farmer's market, but in Hawaii, lovely.
Okay. Good luck to you, Don.
Thank you.
Shall we begin? All right, please make a selection.
A.
All right.
A.
Here's a new game, folks.
Okay.
Inflation has gotten so bad.
How bad has it gotten, Gene?
Well, I'll tell you how bad it's gotten, Gene? Brett traded her blank for a 5-pound bag of sugar. All right. Oh, boy, that's quick. All right, briskly, folks. Quickly. You finished?
Yep.
Go. All right. Ready, here we go. Don, inflation's gotten so bad that Brett traded her blank for a 5-pound bag of sugar.
Traded one of her wigs.
Traded her wig for a 5-pound bag of sugar. Okay, Clifton, maybe see it.
Traded a girdle.
A girdle for a 5-pound bag. What did Brett say to Brett's question?
Brett don't wear a girdle. She wig. Don't all hang on. Wig.
For you, Gary.
Her body.
Traded her body for a 5-pound bag. I mean, that's inflation. What do you say?
Overpriced, too.
I know. What would we trade a precious do? Wig?
Her wig. That's two for you, Don. What did you got there, Richard?
I
mean?
Knew when you could get her for 2 cubes. Wig.
Wig. There's another one. And Brandy?
I know, Brett. Her son.
Traded her son. Dear me. Okay, so that's 3 for you. Your first round question comes up later. Right now, this for you.
You're kidding.
Thank you all for doing your terrific things. Gene Rayburn Match Game is 75. Join us next time. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game 75. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Stay tuned for Title Tales next over most of these CBS stations.